Raider Nation, what's going on? You're watching the Raider Sport. Here's our post-game reaction to the Raiders' 17-15 loss to the Washington football team. And I just want everyone right now to go down in the comments and spam WTF because I don't really know what this football team is. They're very hard to be able to put my finger on. You have a phenomenal game plan. I thought up against the Dallas Cowboys, you went 36-33. And this game to me is just piss-poor coaching. Rich Bisaccia, Greg Olson, I don't know who the hell was the guy calling plays in today's game, but you should be ashamed of yourselves. It just blows my mind that you have 10 days to be able to prepare for Washington, and then that was the offensive game plan that you were able to come up with. DC was just checking the ball down. You barely played Foster Moreau. You barely played DeSean Jackson. At this point, nobody deserves here on the offensive side of the football to come back next year. I get it. It's a good story with Bisaccia. Greg Olson's getting his first real time to call some plays. But it's clear today to me that Bisaccia is not a good head coach. He's a good special teams guy, bad head coach, and Greg Olson has no business calling plays. So is the Raiders season over? Why for yes, or I want you to go ahead and type N for no down in the comments section. I mean, I'm always going to be team N for no for the simple fact of until the season is over, that's when it all comes down to it because you can still win your final five games. Now, you still got to win four out of the next five. Not going to be easy, but I'm hoping this team's able to do it, but you're sitting here right now with a 6-6 record, and with the AFC playoff picture, again, this hasn't been updated, but, you know, here it is. Raiders are 6-6. The Ravens right now, they're still playing. The Pittsburgh Steelers, they're still playing right now. So we'll try to be able to figure out what's going to happen with these games. The Sunday night game's a big one to watch between the Kansas City Chiefs and the Denver Broncos, so a lot of still games going on here, but at the end of the day, I still think the Raiders have a chance to make the playoffs. But it looks like another midseason collapse, and it's going to be another very, very frustrating end of the year. Hopefully I'm totally wrong, though. All right, guys, let's get some questions here on the show, some reactions. This first one's coming in from Way Too Real. It's Carr's fault. Defense didn't stop them from making a field goal. I mean, what you're saying here, you're saying Carr shouldn't get blamed. Merrick dropped a pick six, yes. But the fact that the Raiders' offense is only able to put up 15 points, that is on Derek Carr. That is on the overall offensive game plan. I mean, in the beginning, Carr missed a touchdown to Zay Jones. He missed a wide open to DeSean Jackson for a big-time first down. Watch the game film. This was a bad game for DC, and I don't really care what anybody says about it. I've protected DC for a long time, but I'm also not going to say it's not on Olson. It's more on Bisaccia and Olson for having the game plan that they did because it was disgraceful. But I also don't think Carr brought his A game, and the roller coaster of Derek Carr continues. Let's go to Joe below. That's the last time I put hope in an effing coin. Yeah, I'm with you. So, again, the coin predicted the Raiders to win this game, go 7-5, make the playoffs. It's the first time the coin's been wrong, and I'm with you, done with the coin. Let's go to Joshio 5000. I need that Renfrow jersey size medium. Well, luckily for you, we do actually have some Raiders jerseys going on right now, and why don't we just go ahead and show it right now? So if you guys want a Raiders jersey, you can go to chatsports.com/Raiders jersey, whether it's a Hunter Renfrow, whether it's a Derek Carr. You're also going to get it before Christmas time. So I know a lot of people out there are like, man, I need jerseys. I need awesome gift ideas. These are the lowest priced jerseys that I've been able to find. So if you go to chatsports.com/Raiders jerseys, that link is available for y'all in the chat. It's also available in the link below. I mean, we got hundreds of different types of jerseys. So if you go to that link, find what you want. They got big and tall from extra small, I believe, all the way up to like 5XL. But if you need a Renfrow, Jacobs, Carr, all the goods, chatsports.com/Raiders jerseys. Go to William Blair. Yo, it was the coaching. I mean, you're right. The coaching sucked today. They just look like they've never prepared for an NFL team. And Washington's biggest weakness is going the middle of the field. The Raiders did not go to the middle of the field until late in the game. And once you know it, you start attacking the middle of the field and good things happen. You score a touchdown. But, you know, for you to be able to hold a team to 17 points, you need to be able to win those games. The offense sucked. The defense, sure, you gave that first drive touchdown, but I was actually impressed by the way the defense was able to step up. But it really came down to not being able to make plays when it mattered the most. Washington made plays at the end of the game. This was a 7-6 ball game going into the fourth quarter. Washington made plays. The Raiders didn't. Good teams make plays. Bad teams don't. I'm not saying the Raiders are bad, but are they? They are who they thought they were. An average, mediocre team that's going to let us down. We'll see. So let me know, guys. Right now, as it stands, the Raiders are 6-6. You got the Chiefs. You got the Colts. You got the Browns, the Chargers, and the Broncos. You got to win four out of your next five to make the playoffs, realistically. How many games will the Raiders win? I'm still going to stick to my prediction at 10-7, but don't feel very confident about it. Let's go to Wild on 14. The season isn't over, but the playoffs are. It's time for the players to prove they have heart and deserve to be here next year. So that's actually a part that I do agree with. With the amount of one-year contracts that the Raiders have, this is the time where if you want to be back in the silver and black, if you want a new contract next season when the salary cap goes up, yeah, you better show up the last half of the season because that's when it matters the most. In terms of the playoffs, hopes over? No, you can still absolutely make the playoffs. Is it likely? No, it's not. But the playoffs, they are still a chance. Ty Davis, you're next up here on the Raiders Report, my man. My team is garbage, and it wasn't defense. This week, it was not defense, and they made adjustments. The offense did not make adjustments. Bad coaching, bad quarterback play, or average quarterback play, I'll say. But also your receivers, Brian Edwards can't get open. Zay Jones struggles to catch a ball late in that game, though I thought there was some pass interference there, but I can also understand not the no call. But the fact that Hunter Renfrow, Foss Moreau weren't used as much as what I would like to see, the fact that the Raiders didn't use Foss Moreau, that alone is bad coaching. And DeSean Jackson. Let's go to Zornell. Still need an impact player on defense to win a game like today. Again, I don't necessarily 100% agree with that. It's just you have a lot of young players, and unfortunately you didn't make plays when it mattered. I mean, you held a team in the NFL to 17 points, and one of the drives was literally presented by the officiating. I mean, the officiating, the one call on Johnathan Abram was terrible. The no call on Maxx Crosby for holding. The roughing the passer on Maxx Crosby, he literally said out loud, the NFL is effing soft. And if you think that the NFL is soft, I want you to go down in the comments right now and type soft, because the one drive was literally because the NFL officiating crew at times is totally lost and confused, which I don't get it, man. If you guys want to flag football league, just put flags on the guys already. Now, if you love the Raiders, if you want free videos every single day, hit that big red button that says subscribe, youtube.com/Raiders Report. Now, I'm going to be in tomorrow for my Overreaction Monday video, and I'm just going to tell you right now, if you want some coaches' heads to roll, you're going to like tomorrow's show. I'm going to rip on Derek Carr a little bit, but it's going to be a lot of coaching. There's no doubt about it. And then also, I'm going to be live on Tuesday, 6 p.m. Eastern Time, 3 p.m. Pacific. Bottom line, I want to be the first Raiders channel that hits 100,000 on YouTube, and I'm pretty damn confident we're going to be that channel. Let's go to Top Beats. Mitch, this game justifies removal of the entire staff. I agree. Our season is over. Carr blowing the second point to Edwards justifies a Carr trade. Here's the issue. I don't know too many teams that are going to trade. I mean, what do you want for Carr? Because I know most Raider fans will say, oh, I want a first-round pick. If an NFL team knows that you want to get rid of them and that Carr doesn't want to play for you because Carr literally said, I don't want to play for anybody else besides the Raiders, if I'm an NFL team, I'm not giving up a first-round pick for him. So would you give up a second or a third-round pick for Carr? I personally won't. I think he's going to be around next season. But, yeah, Carr missed Brian Edwards on a two-point conversion. That definitely hurt this team. And, again, when it mattered the most, Carr couldn't get it done today. Whether you like the truth or not, that's the truth. Carr was not good enough today to come away with a win, but neither was the Raiders coaching staff, and neither was the entire offense. Let's go to Michael Hossian. If the Chiefs lose, how's our standings for the wild card? Also, we checked down too many times and barely threw to Jackson. Well, Jackson was barely even in the game. I don't even know if he had 20 snaps in this game. Going into halftime, you had one play of over 30 yards in terms of a pass attempt. What you did so great the week before against Cowboys was you threw the ball deep. They just didn't do it this week. I don't have an answer for the game plan. I've said it 100 times now. This loss is going to rest on the shoulders of Rich Bisaccia, Greg Olson, for not having his team out there in the right position, I guess. Go to Dez Magic. We lose all these winnable games. What the hell? Tired of watching garbage, man. Like, what? I always vote for us to win, but at least I'm not gambling. You're right, at least you're not gambling. I lost my bet today. I had the Raiders minus one. I really thought they were going to be able to come out on top, but unfortunately, that's also the sport of gambling. But I do think I went 4-1 in my other bets today, so we'll see. Now, I want you guys to go ahead and grade the Raiders offense up against the Washington football team. A, B, C, D, or F. I don't know why I got the hiccups right now, but I do. A, B, C, D, or F. I'm going to give the offense a D grade. The first half was a disgrace in terms of overall offensive coaching, overall execution. The checkdowns, just way too many checkdowns, man. But I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to give the Raiders offense a D grade. I mean, as I look right now in terms of team stats, he had 22 first downs, 310 total yards. It's bad. It's bad. Let's go to Sam Russo. Zay Jones had opportunities, couldn't make a play, he's trash. I don't think Zay Jones is trash. Zay Jones is exactly what Zay Jones is. the fact that he's out on the field as much as he is kind of shows where our wide receiver room is right now. Zay Jones on most NFL teams at best, absolute best, is a wide receiver four. Unfortunately, right now, he's the guy getting more snaps than any receiver on our team. I'm just going to say it's because he's in the best shape, but I don't understand the coaching staff at this point. I just think that their ability to be able to make right decisions, it just people have their football IQ is bad. I mean, that's really what it comes down to. The Raiders coaching staff football IQ is bad. Let's go to Christian. NFL soft and rigged refs, blind Raiders always unstable and find ways to lose rather than win. I mean, the defense didn't get a stop late when it mattered the most. And, yeah, I mean, we're going to go back. We're going to look at Trevon Merrick dropping a pick six near the end of the game. And then because that drop happened, the field goal was able to be made by Washington. But missed two-point conversion this game is not just the fourth quarter. This is goes back to all the previous bad play calls. Mariota had, what, two, three snaps in this game. It led to two first downs and two of the best plays I've seen the Raiders make. I don't understand how you see the Raiders' offense move when you do these fun creative plays with Mariota, and then for you to not go back to it when the game's on the line. Again, it's people not being prepared because they've never been in this situation before. Let's go to the Gonzo 6. Merrick had a pick and dropped it. Shake my head. I'm disappointed. I can't wait for a collapse for next year. I'm definitely not excited for that. I'm hoping. I'm always going to keep my head high. I'm always going to keep my faith because I think that's what being a Raider fan's about. Even if it's Raiders win, lose, or tie, you know, Raider Nation till I die, and I'm going to stick by that. Let's go to Jared. Carr's the most consistent, inconsistent quarterback. It's crazy. He's been consistently inconsistent, I think is what you're saying. And, yes, I mean, the fact of there's some days he's like, wow, I mean, it's amazing how good he looks. And there's other games you're like, he's not even a top 20 quarterback. Today, he didn't play like a top 20 quarterback. Let's go to Way Too Real. Raiders playoffs start now. And their playoffs started, you know, basically coming out of the bye when you're 5-2. But the fact that since 1980, it's like 76% of the teams that start the year out 3-0, they make the playoffs. Since that 3-0 start, you're 3-6. Let's just face it, the Raiders right now, they're not a playoff caliber team, but that doesn't mean they can't make the playoffs. Let's go to Danny Boy, 1-1-2-0. Offense, wet the bed. Shout out to the defense for holding it down. Now, I will say this has actually probably been one of the better games by the Raiders defense because since week 10 entering the game, the Raiders were allowing 35.3 points per game, which is ranked dead last in the NFL. Now, I definitely think some of those numbers were skewed because of the Cincinnati game and because of how bad the offense played. But, I mean, now we've seen five games without Ruggs, the Raiders offense, and basically only one of those games was decent. That was against Cowboys. Cowboys aren't that good defensively. So, now what I want you guys to do is rate the Raiders defense up against the Washington football team from a scale from 0 to 100, 0 being terrible, 100 it was great. I'm going to go ahead and give them a 75 overall grade. They played well, but the Merrick pick when it mattered the most, some bad penalties. Actually, I'm probably going to go ahead and give them an 80. They at least deserve a B. They played well, held them to about 300 total yards of offense. What is it? They held them to 298 total yards of offense. So I'm going to give them an 80 grade, but defenses need to be able to make plays at the end of the game, and the Raiders didn't do that. Manny V, yo, Mitch, horrendous game, but where are you getting those baseball-style jerseys? I get them on Instagram, and if anybody wants me to try to find them, I can try to send you a link, but hit me up on IG, Mitchell Renz 365, and if I miss any of your guys' questions during today's show, during today's post-game reaction, please, easiest way to get in touch with me, slide in my DMs at Mitchell Renz 365. Mervin, are you as sick as me right now? I'm disappointed, and I feel like a parent where I'm like, I'm not upset, I'm disappointed. And, you know, I've only been a fan of the Raiders, honestly, for a short amount of time, and I told myself I couldn't call myself a true Raider fan until I actually went to a game, experienced the Coliseum, and experienced that entire atmosphere. So I've only been a fan since 2019, and that's just me being 100% real with you. So people who I know have dedicated their lives to this team that rep it all the time, I'm sure they're a lot more sick than me. But, yeah, I mean, I'm frustrated. I put my heart and soul into covering this team. And I know a lot of people here at Chat Sports who do the exact same. And, you know, it's frustrating when you put in the amount of work that you do with a fan base as amazing as it is. And then the coaching staff puts out the performance that they did today. I mean, the coaching staff should be ashamed of themselves. Go to Alex Gonzalez. Fire the refs, coaching staff, and the players. I mean, not all the Raiders players played bad today. I mean, let's just be real. Sometimes you can't do much if your coaches don't put you in the right position to win. And that's what I saw today. The Raiders offense didn't put them in the right position to win. Defense played okay. Saw Malcolm Kuntz get a sack. I thought Divine Diablo got picked apart a little bit. Brandon Faison definitely got picked on. But if you want to talk about a bad game, the worst game today that I saw for a Raiders defensive player was Trevon Merrick, and I don't know if it's all that close. Noah Garcia, Bisaccia got to go. Greg Olson got to go. Carr, I'm very disappointed. We are not going to the playoffs. Love the show, Mitch. Noah, appreciate it. But, yeah, I mean, Bisaccia, he's not going to come back. And I said that the day that Gruden got fired. There's no way Bisaccia is going to come back unless they literally make a deep playoff run and win the Super Bowl, right? That's not going to happen at this point. Greg Olson, he's definitely going to go as well. You need a new OC. Very interested to see what happens with Joe Brady. I mean, Joe Brady got released today by Carolina, and he was actually a guy in my top three for Raiders head coaching candidates. I think it has a little bit to do with the fact that he was talking to some college coaches or college teams with all these, you know, guys getting fired and whatnot, but we'll end up seeing what happens. Bottom line is this. I love y'all. We're going to still be making you guys videos all the time, so if you haven't subscribed yet, make sure you hit that big red button that says sub underneath.